Because let's talk about the fact that this is a general election that is also going to be sort of really determined by the fact that you have 130 million new voters. Now, out of these 130 million new voters who are first-time voters, actually, we don't know exactly what the number is that are actually below the age of 35, because that's not data that the Election Commission has at the moment. But what we do know is that nearly half of India's, or more than half of India's population, is currently below the age of 35. So I think it's safe to guess that there is a very large chunk of India's population who would classify as young. I don't any longer, but who would classify as young voters, who are perhaps going to hold the key to this general election. So the question we're asking is, what are the issues that matter to them? Is it going to be national security? Is it going to be jobs? Is it going to be both, or strong leadership? What is it actually going to be? And in fact, let me take that question straight away to you, Akash, as I'm sure someone who does qualify in the young voter category. What do you think matters the most?
That's, thank you for the compliment. Nidhi, I do a lot of social media, and I'm telling you, I am the older group. And I'll tell you why, is because recently one went to a college to shoot for a show, and we were just having a discussion, and I thought that I am very savvy because I use Twitter. And we were just having a conversation, and we said, how many people use Twitter? Two hands went up. How many people use Instagram? And almost every hand went up. So the thing is that technology is changing so rapidly, is that emails are out, websites are out, even Facebook is out, and Twitter is out, and now Instagram, and tomorrow, of course, it would be Snapchat or something else. Are the aspirations of the youth being tracked at this point of time by the political parties? Absolutely not. And I really think that there is one thing that maybe we are missing the scope, and BJP used to talk about this a lot. Whoever wins the colleges wins the election. And 2013, BJP swept the university elections, and that resulted, and that impact was seen in 2014. It is very important to note that if you take into account all the major colleges that have gone to elections, ABBP has done very bad. So in the youth, if I was in the BJP, I would be very worried, is am I overlooking the fact that the youth just wants to have a good time? They want their freedom of choice. Is that a problem? That is one. And B, on development, Congress hasn't been able to give any concrete alternative. This whole business of just politicking Modi versus Rahul, I don't think the youth enjoys it. Every time I put out a video, you know what I get as a satirist also? It's not my job to give solutions. They say, why are you only making fun? Where is the solution? I think that solution orientation is going to dent all political parties. They don't have it.
You know, that's interesting you say that, and we've got another sort of youthful face, Raghav Chadha of the AAP, joining us as well. And I'm sure, Raghav, you definitely qualify below the 35 thing. But anyway, just to ask you, you know, as a young political leader and as someone from the AAP, do you think, as Akash says, that India's political parties really are not in sync with what young people want? I mean, I asked this question, for instance, of the Congress, which I'll ask Salman as well. Rafale, yes, is an important issue. But is it something that is connecting with voters the way, say, the jobs report would? The fact that unemployment is at a 45-year high. I think a lot of young people are going to care about that stuff and want to see political leaders and the opposition raise that, not just to attack the Modi government, but to give your blueprint. What are your ideas? How will you generate employment? Are you all doing enough of that?
No, absolutely. Let me at the outset state that India is a very young country, as has been pointed out right at the beginning of the show. We have 50% of our population below the age of 25. We have 65% of our population below the age of 35. And I was studying this report, which very clearly articulated this point, that the gap between the average age of the Union Cabinet and the average age of the country, India, is the highest across the world. So therefore, we are a young country, but we are underrepresented as far as the politics of this country is concerned. As far as the issues are concerned, there are a lot of issues, and as somebody who comes from the youth brigade, I can say there are a lot of issues that trouble the youngsters. For example, jobs, shrinking disposable income, the way the freedoms have been threatened, the freedom of expression, we are being told what to wear, what to eat, who to love, so on and so forth. And I fundamentally believe that, you know, ever since I've become a part of a political setup, I've interacted with so many youngsters, and I can say this in no uncertain terms that the youth of India is far more liberal than the current regime, and therefore we are not merely concerned about a lack of employment opportunities, lack of quality education, but also about our freedoms, freedom of expression and speech, since I think every civil liberty that has been given to the citizens of this country has been systematically assaulted by this current regime. And therefore I feel that the youngsters will play a very decisive role as far as the 2019 Lok Sabha polls are concerned. You rightly point out that yes, we have seen the highest unemployment in the organized sector over the last four and a half decades. And as far as the unorganized sector is concerned, which employs more than 90% of India's workforce, we don't even have the figures of unemployment or employment in the unorganized sector, because the government has not does not have the requisite paraphernalia to measure unemployment. And the unorganized sector had taken a massive beating due to ill-conceived policy decisions like the GST and the demonetization. So I feel lack of jobs, lack of quality education, and lack of employability skills in our educational institutions would perhaps be the biggest issues, apart from the freedoms of expression
okay.
and speech and
that's an interesting
that
argument. That's an interesting argument. I want to take that to Vivek Reddy. That what Raghav Chadha is saying is that apart from jobs, it's values. It's the values of free speech, expression, the way we want to live our lives, the way we want to eat food. These are the things that matter to young people, Mr. Reddy. I think you're also young, Mr. Reddy. So what do you think?
I think, Nidhi, these things are overhyped by the AAP spokesperson. Let me tell you one thing. In this country, there has been no restraint of freedom of expression. There has been no attempt to, pull in or rope in any form
right.
of a habit or any form of a manner of behavior or culture. I think
what was the beef
both
ban?
This regime
what was
and in the previous NDA regime, there has been no such incident or no such case of trying to, pull in people to certain behavior. I don't know where Mr. Raghav Chadha gets it from. And today, at least youngsters of this nation, Nidhi, they are very clear that what matters is, of course, jobs, which there is a very healthy environment for getting jobs in India. The recent CII survey says that almost 14.9 million jobs have been created. This is one. Second thing is the larger issue. How secure we are as a nation. That is also of serious concern. Why were the previous regimes not up to the mark in protecting this nation? This is also something the youth think of. And as a society, where are we heading? Today, India is jumped from the 9th largest world economy to the 6th largest world economy. So that is the financial part of it. Even as a society, we are moving with development. The agenda that is brought in by this government is taken all fronts of development together and taken the nation forward. I think the youth today in this nation are looking at these aspects, and they don't have any grievance regarding freedom of expression, as my learned friend would try to put it. This is a clear case where the government has striven and worked hard. Ultimately, perception-wise, Nidhi, take it perception-wise. Here is a person, Mr. Narendra Modi, who is working hard, who is striving to get the maximum benefit for this country, who has identified himself as the true Sevak, and whose efforts are sincere. You see that earnestness coming out. Unlike other leaders, if you look at the other leaders, there is no earnestness. All of them have had various scandals that have stuck on them. So
right.
this is what the youth of this nation want, and they are finding it in Modi. And there is a clear upsurge. There's an upswing.
Okay, well, did you do a survey about this upswing? Is there a survey you can cite? I mean, sorry to just sort of just point this out, but I'm just asking, did you miss the headlines?
The survey was done in the recent...
If you go out and ask people instead of sitting in the studio...
We ask people every day.
Instead of the studio.
No. Mr. Reddy, don't worry. I've been doing this job for 20 years.
Please
probably a lot longer than you've been a BJP spokesperson.
No.
So don't tell me about how to conduct my job.
You should go out to the field.
No, so should you. And perhaps you should realize that unemployment is a serious issue with the young people. It's a serious issue with older people. Then you wouldn't be talking through your hat.
There are facts and figures, Nidhi.
Yeah,
there are facts and figures.
Read the CMI report.
Some people are using fake
news.
No,
what
the
fake
news?
NSSO was fake.
Who is the
CMI?
It does not have status.
about NSSO?
Do you know the CII report, Confederation of Indian Industry?
What about the NSSO
An article
report?
That has come on India
you
Business
called
today.
It a draft report.
It says 14.9 million jobs.
You called it a draft report.
And did
report.
You, Times of India, a month ago I said, there is a hike in recruitment. Times of India.
So?
About
what is the Times
said,
of India? It's the Bible?
Hike in recruitment.
It is the Quran?
Times of India
it is
report.
The Gita? So, Times of India can't get it wrong. What
well,
about
see,
the NSSO?
CMI is not
ask
the Quran.
Me about NSSO.
CMI is not the Quran. You
what
want
about
to
NSSO?
On, you want to
what
rely
about
on
NSSO?
Report that is anti-government.
Mr. Reddy,
that
what
is
about
not the Quran.
NSSO?
That
what
is
about
not the
Quran. NSSO report in December?
CMI is a fake report.
45-year high of unemployment.
The
what about that?
CMI
no one will talk about NSSO because
that
it's
we should not bomb Pakistan. What else can you take about CMI report?
What about
the author of CMI report says we should not bomb Pakistan. He comes and gives opinions on foreign relations and policy.
Didi, can I?
Salman Sohn.
And you, I mean, you
this,
expect
this
us
guy
to
just shouts.
You're not answering on the NSSO
you know,
report.
The this guy is all about, you know, look, I mean, if we have to believe this shouting person,
Nidhi
whatever his name is, Mr. Reddy, please, now, let us also talk. If you think that unemployment is down, great. If you think that the freedom of expression in India is at an all-time high, great. If you think that Narendra Modi is not corrupt and not passing on 30,000 crore rupees to the Reliance, great. You can believe all these things. You can also believe that there is no fake news. But the fact of the
That's
matter
the
is...
That's the biggest lie.
That, as we see it...
The Rafale.
The government... Wait, just keep quiet. Just keep quiet for a minute. Just relax. Just please stay cool.
Please go ahead.
The government's own report, which the government refused to publish, said that unemployment is at a 45-year high. Now let us please, for God's sake, if you don't care about anything, let us at least care about our children. We need policies that help create good, decent jobs, because these kids are seeing the world on
but
their
Mr.
mobile
Soth,
phones
can I
and
ask
they say,
what
if
is
those
the
other people
plan
can have,
to create jobs?
Wait a second.
What is
Let
the
me,
Congress plan?
I will tell you. I'm here. I study economics. I'll tell you. And I'll tell you what our manifesto is going to come. I mean, I can't divulge what it's coming up with, but I can give you the broad framework. But our young people are seeing all the good things that people have in other parts of the world. They want similar things. They don't want too much. They want a decent job. They want to have fun in their lives. They want a good life too. They deserve it. And we have to help them. But if we deny that there is trouble in the economy, then we are actually hurting them. Okay, that's one. You can use any propaganda. You're free to do it. You can feel happy about it, but I think you're going to lose the election. Now, what is the Congress Party's vision? I think the manifesto is going to come, but I can give you a broad framework. In India, if we want to create jobs, we have to level with each other. The only way, in my opinion, to create jobs is to increase, to expand economic activity. And the only way to do that is by letting businesses, private sector, do their work. And we have to get out of their way. The government has to get out of the way, especially out of the way of small and medium enterprises. We need to cut regulations in a massive way. We need to have a much better tax system. We need to kind of get
okay,
rid
so
of
you're giving
tax
us some idea.
We need to
one
get
second.
Rid of
okay,
Inspector
Raj. So
I'm giving
idea
you an
of what
idea of what
is.
Can happen.
Okay.
That
Salman,
is
just
the only
second.
Way
Let
to
get
create
a
jobs
comment
in
from
India.
Sagrika
the
on
government
this.
Will not necessarily create
so,
jobs.
Okay. So I think we need to be a little more political in the way we're approaching this. I think rather than, you know, come up with first principles of mother's milk and apple pie and say we're going to create jobs, we're going to do this and we're going to do that, I think we need to talk a little bit specifically about the fact that youth is not a monolithic identity. It's not a monolithic entity out there. There's rural youth, there's urban youth, there's youth divided into according to caste. Now, let's face it, in 2014, Mr. Modi got the youth vote. One out of two young persons voted for the BJP in 2014, right? That's the CSDS survey of 2014. In fact, the BJP got double the number of votes that the Congress got. I think, as far as the BJP is concerned, there is a greater attempt to reach the youth through the Namo app, through Facebook, through Twitter, and through political messaging. You know, the BJP has been sharper off the mark in actually projecting younger leaders. For example, a Devendra Fadnavis. Today, he is a credible face of the BJP. He's 46 years of age. He's the chief minister. Has the Congress opted for young chief ministers? No. I believe the Congress missed a beat in not projecting either a Sachin Pilot or a Jyotiraditya Sindhya in 2018. They could have missed. They fell back on the old one. They could have projected one. Maybe it was not politic to project two. They could have projected one. It's about messaging. It's about the political symbol. It's about reaching the young. The young are wanting newness. Now, you can give your old slogans about we want business and we want to facilitate business and we want to take away controls. I mean, this is mother's milk and apple pie. But the fact is, you have to give political messaging.
Quick response.
You have to give political messaging. And that, I'm afraid, the Congress is failing at and needs to address.
Sagarika, I'm sorry, I disagree with you. And I'll tell you why. First of all, this is not motherhood and apple pie. Without greater economic activity and without actually unfettering and unleashing
who can deny that?
There is no hope.
Who's going to argue with that?
Listen to me. We'll have concrete proposals that you can vet for yourself, and then you can tell us whether that is really generic or if it is specific. So on the other hand, on the other issue of young leaders in the Congress Party, I'm sorry. I think we spend too much time on Twitter. If you look at the Congress Party's organization and what has happened in the last several months, you look at our organization is filled with young people at organizational positions, not just at the AICC at the top level, but at our PCC levels. So we have young people.
But don't you think you missed a beat? In 2018, don't you think you missed a beat?
We've taken. Look, Sagarika. Ultimately, we have to build our organization. And the way what we have done it is we have actually filled people in key positions. We fill those with younger people. At the same time, we respect experience. We have married experience with our youth.
I think what Sashika is saying is that you had a good chance.
There was a good chance.
It's one of the two states to have a younger leader, and that would have sent out a very different message. I have just time for last comments. Akash, to you first and then Raghav. Akash.
So very, very, very quickly, Nidhi, I agree with a lot of points that are being made. Obviously, the messaging, it's not a question of how many people you get. It's the message that you sent out. BJP has been able to get that very strong message that we have a very hardworking prime minister and this government is trying very hard. The common sentiment is that bhai koshish to kar rahe hain. So there is no debate about that. However, I have this, I was just trying to, I would really strangle myself with this cable if somebody tells me that there is no lack of freedom of expression. Say you are hardworking, say that your security is strong, say you've given Pakistan a strong response, that's absolutely okay.
Absolutely.
But trust me, when you talk to the youth, they all know, they are all scared. They say, aap kaise kar lete ho? Hum to nahi bol paate hain. Will this reflect out? Because last point, Nidhi, what got BJP wrong in 2004 was their arrogance. You see the same arrogance come out, whether it's Mr. Reddy here or any other political party. What happens is that if you connect
Youth
today don't like this arrogance. They don't want any arrogance from any person. They all want grounded people. They would vote for a stupid person rather than an arrogant person.
We also don't need misleaders. Akash, we don't need misleading people also.
Well, I saw Akash kind of staring at that wire for about 5 minutes.
I hope you know what you're talking about. It's a very ironical statement you just made. Be very careful of what you're saying. Your bosses are watching you.
We need not be careful. You need not threaten anybody.
Okay.
You need not threaten anybody.
Don't feel what you say can threaten anybody.
This statement is going to be recorded and being played. We don't need misleading leaders. Misleading leaders.
Well, Nidhi, I
all right.
Already.
You have done that just in the previous slot you did.
Okay, Raghav Chadha.
Mere 15 lakh de do.
Well, Nidhi, I have already made that point of the. I've already made the point that the youth of India is equally concerned about.
You are showing how shameful is your conduct,
speech and expression. And
Mr.
today,
Akash,
the youth of India
could go to more shameful levels, and only you are capable
streets,
of that.
Even with their own sister, because you never know that when the anti-Romeo squad will come and haul you up or put you behind bars or beat you up. So therefore, I think the youth of India certainly, when they go out to cast their vote, exercise their franchise this time around, would be
certainly cognizant of the fact that we are being told for the last 5 years what to eat, what to wear, whom to love, and the way in which we need to conduct our lives. Secondly, the problems and the problem that the aspirations of the youth of India have not been adequately addressed by these leading political parties is also because young generation, youngsters, are underrepresented in politics, as Ms. Sagrika Ghosh rightly pointed out. Now, there are a lot of entry barriers for the youngsters in, as far as entering politics is concerned. You need media power, you need muscle power, you need political godfathers above all to make it big in politics. Unlike new political startups like the Aam Aadmi Party that have actually given the young people to come at the forefront and take responsibility. For example, I was appointed as the national spokesperson of Aam Aadmi Party when I was 24. I was appointed as the national treasurer of Aam Aadmi Party when I was 27. I was appointed as a candidate for the upcoming Lok Sabha post when I was 29. So therefore, and there are so many
29 years
people
old.
Working in the Aam Aadmi Party who are young.
No, but that's a great point.
And are at the helm.
No, that's a great point. That's a great point you've made about the underrepresentation
the
of
heads
people
the social
under
media.
Yeah.
In the Aam Aadmi.
But you know, I'm this has been a fascinating conversation, I'm happy to say I have to leave. But it's nice to see that we even got a smile from Mr. Reddy at the end of it, and Akash has stopped playing with that wire which he wanted to strangle himself with. So thank you very much to all of you for joining us. May this be a wonderful election in which we can continue to debate each other. Thanks a lot. Good night.